Economists and the opposition are rubbishing an attempt to blame the Reserve Bank for Victoria's mounting debt. Tomorrow's budget will outline how we'll repay the billions borrowed through COVID. State political reporter Mark Santamartino.
For decades, treasurers from Michael O'Brien to Kim Wells, John Lenders to John Brumby, have fronted cameras on the day before the budget, an appointment Tim Pallas almost missed. Its name's a secret, but its mission is not. Start paying back the money Victoria borrowed through COVID.
Tomorrow's budget will show that under Labor, Victoria is broke.
Between 2019 and the middle of 2022, the government spent almost $36 billion combating COVID. That's less than a third of Victoria's overall debt, which is predicted to hit $165 billion and keep climbing.
I think we're going to see a fairly tough budget. In other words, there won't be a lot of handouts in it. If anything, there will be spending cuts.
This will not be something that will be affecting hardworking Victorian families who've already had enough with 11 interest rate rises over the past 12 months.
Celebrating the removal of a milestone 70th level crossing, the Deputy Premier was heckled by traders at Surry Hills. Jacinta Allen dodging questions about the possibility of new or increased taxes as rate rises and interest payments start to bite.
The debt that was taken on because of the urging of the Reserve Bank.
To blame the RBA, I think, is a bit over the top at this point, particularly given that Victoria does have a higher debt level than other states.
Whoever pays, if it's big business that pays or if it's small business that pays, Victorians pay. That's how it works.
Now, Mark, should Victorians expect any cost of living relief?
Well, Pete, if there was any good news, you'd expect we would have heard about it by now. There's literally been one major budget announcement so far, and that was an increase to the WorkCover premium, effectively a tax hike. It's also been confirmed today that it was Victoria who requested Melbourne Airport Rail Project be reassessed. Effectively, it was our idea to see that project either delayed or scrapped entirely. It really drums home that tomorrow will be about cuts. Jobs will go to protect the Premier's promise to get our books back in the black by 2026. And I can tell you tonight, Pete, we are on track for a surplus that year. That financial year, we're forecasting a $1 billion surplus, and it'll look a little bit better the year after that. Tomorrow, a $1.2 billion surplus will be announced for the year ending June 2027. Pete?